Hey, there you go. Sit down.
What's up, man?
Clear that seat out. Y'all want something to drink? Yeah, you do. Look like I'm talking to two beer men, ain't I? Huh? That's, watch yourselves. Anybody cut? Everybody all right? Okay, let me clean that up. Watch your leg, Joey, because that glass can get in your skin and we can't get it out. Brother, I got a new hobby, man.
A hobby?
Yes. Mixology, man. This is my new thing.
Cause you know you gotta go to school for bartending. You know,
I don't have to go to school for nothing, okay? I took an app.
An app?
Yes, download the app on my phone, Mixology app, read it for 2 minutes, I got it all in my head, bro.
Kev, people study for years to become good bartenders. You gonna learn from an app?
Same people that study for years are the same people that created the app, so I don't have to study for years, Harry.
Give me a lemon drop.
That's not an app. I don't know how to do that.
All right, let me make it simple. Give me a gin and juice.
That's easy.
Are we talking about drinks from the States? Or are you guys in Japan? Where y'all at? Let's talk about
the ingredients are in the name, Kev.
Brother, if I'm a mixologist, let me mix. Okay? Let me bring to you what I do best. Can we do that? Huh? Ooh, go boy. Huh? Is it a basketball or is it a bottle? Yeah. What do I have?
Hey, man.
Just you want a long pour or a short pour?
I just poured
in
the
glass.
Give
me long. Uh-oh. Still in the glass. Still in a glass. Who like dark? I can't see nothing because I like dark. Boy, watch this. Hit him with it. Splash that on him, right?
You didn't.
Brother, y'all like olives or no?
Grab that one for me. Pass it back to me.
I'm not gonna do this. Come here, Joey.
I'm not gonna do it.
Joey, brother, let me show you something.
I'm done.
Just
man,
let me. Come here. Taste what I got. Harry. Joey. Huh? It's called a doohickey dirt right. Disgusting.
The comedy game is a grind. It's gritty. To get to the top, you gotta go through the underground. I'm talking bars, small rooms, strip clubs. Travel with me and my boys as we spotlight the hottest new comedians in the country. My name is Kevin Hart, and welcome to Heart of the City. Since we're in Philadelphia, I'll take you to my favorite restaurant, Miss Tootsie's. This is where I throw down. We got Lawrence Killebrew, Anthony Moore, and Skeet Carter.
Let me ask you a question. What do you think Philadelphia has done for your comedic tone?
For me, it gave me a little bit of a swag. Because I feel like I can go anywhere and perform.
Philly, we have it. I think it. So that's what I call it.
Yeah, Philly, it teaches you to be yourself.
Okay.
And, like, be comfortable. Like, Philly don't like fake stuff. You gotta come original.
This is my favorite question I like to ask. Worst show?
Yeah, it was one, no chairs, standing only, so.
No chairs?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's just, for everybody at home watching right now, let me explain to you why chairs are important for stand-up comedy. You know, they set the tone of a room. People sit down, it means that a show is coming.
So then they had the rappers go on.
Oh, you follow the rappers.
Then then after that, then they had a twerk contest.
Oh, you followed the twerk contest. This is like a horror film.
So then the host was like, all right, so y'all ready for a comedian? And as soon as he said that, immediately started booing.
Honestly, that might be the worst environment for comedy I've ever heard in my life. Judging by the environment, I'm not gonna say that these were amazing twerkers. It ain't. I think that could be the worst thing in the world. Following a bad twerker? You follow a girl that got booed twerking, you don't stand a chance. The good news is that you're still standing, brother. It's not about when you bomb, it's about surviving the bomb. Warm daddies. That's where we're going tonight. What's the vibe?
Warm daddies, you have to bring the funny because the food is good. So if you ain't funny, they gonna eat that food. So you got to get them out the cornbread, you got to get them out the macaroni and cheese.
You don't wanna hit them for it.
Yeah, if you start hearing nah, nah, pass the salt and pepper, you ain't doing something right.
What does this moment mean for you guys?
Oh, this is everything. I've been waiting for this.
I'm excited about now, but I'm really excited about what's gonna come after this. Like, this is great.
What about you?
I just want the check that they're gonna pay me for this show. Cause my bills is backed up.
It's stuff going on right now.
It's going on. See, they young. I'm a little older, so the check is what's most important for me. I got some backed up bills, bro. They need to post their debt today. I need that now. I'm dead serious. I think I'm playing.
Do you ever put it like this,
right? It's rough, man. It's rough out here in these streets.
But don't you want the fame too?
Listen, man.
Everything else,
I want that check today.
Ha
Philly, make some noise in here. Show them what we got. Show them what we got. Show them what we got.
All right. I don't know about the rest of these comedians I'm about to put on stage. I'm just here to get this money for this cable bill. You understand what I'm saying? Like, it ain't the cable bill per se. It's that bundle, because you never know what's in the bundle till you don't pay that bitch. That's when you get an education. I didn't pay the bundle 1 month. They sent my daughter home from school. It was like 9:30 in the morning. I'm like, why you back so early? She's like, you ain't paid a bundle, Dad? I'm like, tuition is in that bitch? Cable is gangster. You ever call out a cable company like it's something wrong other than the fact that you didn't pay the bill? Give them a piece of your mind? I know I have. Because no matter when you call and be angry, they always pleasant. You want to give them a piece of your mind to answer the phone with a little jingle. Hi, thanks for calling cable. Here to help you. I went right in. I gave them my best North Philly because that's where I'm from. What office you at? I come down there, smack out of everybody. Had to let her know how gangster I was. Cable company let me know how gangster they was. They flicked the lights in my house. They was like, come on, TuRae. Who you think you dealing with? I was like, they locked my refrigerator for a couple hours. It's real. Cut my grandmother's oxygen off. I'm like, hold tight, grandma. I'm on the phone with them. You bastards. Ladies, let me know if you ain't got your cable package right. I ain't got to stay. I'm over this one young lady, how she's like, make yourself at home. I'm gonna go slip into something more comfortable. I'm like, know what that means. I got cable at home. She come back downstairs. I'm in the living room looking around. She's like, what you looking for? I was like, the cable remote. She's like, I don't have cable. I called my girl to come get me. I was like, baby, ha! This bitch is being disrespectful. Yeah, she don't have no basic or nothing. My girl was like, no basic? Let me come get my boo. Y'all ready to have a good time here tonight? Clap your hands, make some noise.
Coming up, when breaking up with your barber goes bad.
Every time I go into the barber shop, he asks me, where the hell you been? Who keep leaving these marks around your neck?
And then, Snore Wars.
Help me welcome to the stage, Mr. Anthony Moore.
What's up, y'all? Man, I'm at a good point in life, man. I just finished school, graduated St. Joe's University, and yep. But it was tough for me being black at a predominantly white school, because, I mean, white people do certain things differently than black people. Like, I found out that white people can eat macaroni and cheese as a main dish. Never knew that. Seriously, like, my friends invited me over for dinner. I'm looking at the table all confused, like, damn, where is the chicken and greens at? And when did y'all start making this tea unsweetened? Like, but the craziest thing I found out at school is that some white people say the N-word. And not even like racist white people, just your regular wholesome pumpkin spice lovers. Like, true story. I'm hanging out with my friend Jimmy one day, watching a basketball game. Point guard is coming up the court, does an in and out move, loses the ball out of bounds. Jimmy just snaps like, oh my God, this. But I couldn't even be mad because we said it at the same time. Like, I wanted to be upset, but he used it in the right context, man. I was just sitting there amazed, like, well, damn, Jimmy sure knows how to use his d-. Like, he must have Urban Dictionary this, man. Now I also have gay friends, and I'm gonna tell you something. If you don't have some gay friends already, you need to get you some, because gay people are unstoppable right now. Like, I'm telling you, it seems like they get parades once a month. They getting laws passed. They almost got Chick-fil-A open on Sundays. Like, I was, that lemonade, oh my God. That lemonade is heavenly, right? Like, it's like it's made from Beyonce sweat, man. Like, look, it's two groups of people you gotta get in good with. It's two groups of people that run the world. The first group of gay people, the second group of Jewish people. So if I ever get in legal trouble, my lawyer is gonna be the gayest Jew I could find. Like, I'm telling you, he won't come in the courtroom with a nice rainbow yarmulke, tailor Versace suit, and not just a regular one, like a suit from the closet Versace came out of. Like he won't play the part, man. Just walk in the courtroom all happy and energetic, like, well, shalom, Your Honor. Like, like, this is my client. My name is Devontae Bernstein. Like, oh. The prosecution needs a recess, man. Didn't know he was getting Devontae. Hey, man, it's crazy. It's like, I'm just happy I'm getting on TV while I still got some of my hairline left, man. It's just. I'm having relationship problems right now. Not with my girl, but I have two different barbers, and I'm not sure what to do because how I got in this situation, my original barber got locked up. So, you know, at first, I'm sending him letters with pictures of me growing out my hair to let him know I'm out here holding him down like I'm supposed to. But, you know, like, I'm out here, like, on the outside, I still got needs, so I started seeing somebody else because I was feeling vulnerable. And now that my barber just got out, I don't know how to tell them about each other because it's like I care about them both, but man, it's just so messed up now because every time I go into the barber shop, he questioning me like he my man, asking me where the hell you been, who keep leaving these marks around your neck, and. And then when my barber not there, the other barbers try to seduce me into a haircut, all trying to sweet talk me into the shampoo chair. Like, come on, man, just lay down. He don't ever care about you like that. If he did, he gonna leave you around us. Now, I gotta defend myself. Like, I mean, you seem nice and all, but I don't think we should be doing this. Like, we just met. I don't let anybody touch my hair. Then my barber walking on us, I got the cape around my neck like, no, Earl, it's not what it looks like. But I'm Anthony Moore, y'all.
Keep it locked. More Heart of the City coming right up.
Listen, pay attention, brother. Pay attention to your boy and watch what I do, huh? You want a martini? Martini is what I do. You can't make a martini without the It's gonna be a problem.
I'm newly single. About a year and a half ago, I took the responsibility to move in with my lady. I decided to be a grown man and start a committed relationship and move in. And that was the dumbest I've ever done in my life. Like, I wasn't ready. I wasn't ready. It was so much I didn't know. I would try to spice up the relationship sometimes. So one time, you know, we was talking on the phone. I'm like, babe, I'm about to come home, you know, whatever. She's like, all right, well, I'm about to go take a bath. I was like, hold up, before you take a bath, why don't you FaceTime me in the bathtub? Now I'm thinking, she gonna, you know, call me in the beginning, you know, with the bubbles, the candle, you know, with the wine, you know, all that, hashtag wine down, you know, something like that. She decided to FaceTime me at the end. So I'm looking like, your water dirty as hell. Like, what did you do today? It's 6 o'clock, why are you this dirty? Like, did you change the transmission or something? Like, why is, I didn't get it. Like, she just got really comfortable. Like, she snores now. Yeah, but see, let me get this right. When we dated, she snored. But it was like a cute snore. It was something that I can catch. Had like a rhythm, you know. Normal snore, you know. Like, that's a normal snore. I can fall asleep to that. Now, it's like a pause, and then it was delayed, so I never knew when it was coming. So like, we're in the bed and she just going at it. She just. And I'm like, when is it coming? You know what I'm saying? Because you ever know some people snore, always wake up and look at you like you did something wrong or something like that? Hey, what's going on? No, that's you sounding like that. Then people with snores want to fall asleep first. No, wake up. No, no. Put some rub my back. No, no. I have a big thing about trust. I don't trust women sometimes. Like, if I'm dating you, I need to know that you really like me. And it's hard for me to figure that out, but I think I figured it out for women. Like, if you dating a guy and you want to find out if that guy really likes you, the best thing you can do is tell him everything about you. And I'm not talking about the good either. I'm talking about the bad stuff. Because if a guy really likes you, it doesn't matter what you say. At the end of the day, he's going to find a way to work with it. Prime example, I dated this girl about 2 weeks. I mean, good 2 weeks. It was good 2 weeks. And we was about to go out, and she's like, Lawrence, before we go out again, I got something very important I want to tell you. So I was like, all right, babe, what's up? It's like, Lawrence, listen, I only have 7 toes. What? I was like, ah. 7. She got a fat ass, man. What's the ratio? Say, what are you talking about? I was like, is it 4 and 3? Or is it 5 and 2? Because I don't think I can talk to somebody that got 2 toes on their feet. You know what I'm saying? Because then I got a lot of questions now. Like, which 2 toes is it? Because if it's like the big toe and the pinky toe, then your feet look like this. It's like you can't properly wear socks like this. You know what, man? I have fun with y'all. I'm Lawrence Killebrew. Peace.
Y'all ready to keep this show going? Make some noise and help me welcome to the stage from Philadelphia, comedian Skeet Carter.
What's going on, y'all? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? First of all, I'm excited and I'm pissed off at the same time. Kevin Hart told me to come down here. He said, Skeet, I'm trying to tell you, you're going to find a side chick tonight. From the looks things, I'm going to find a stepmom. All these old ladies are here tonight. I know a cougar convention when I'm at one. I know, yeah, I saw it. And I should have known because when I came in, they was at the front door arguing. First of all, me and my girls are on the list. We are on the list. And when they asked her what names they was, I said, these chicks is old. She was like Gloria, Bernadette, Henrietta. I said, if you don't let these golden girls in, please, so we can start the show. Lisa, I had to call my dad. I said, they are in here tonight. No, the ones you graduated with. He said, yeah. I'm on the phone with him. He said, I'm going to put my outfit on. You know, you get a certain age, I don't know what it is. Fellas, why do you forget how to match colors together? They outfits consist of one color. That's it. They play it safe. My dad, he get dressed. He had a white shirt on, the white pants, the white socks, the white shoes, the white handkerchief, the white hat. Told me some high look. I said, Dad, you look like a loose cigarette. That's what you look like. So somebody gonna smoke you tonight, Dad. What's wrong with you? Y'all, thank y'all so much for laughing, man. Comedian Skeet Carter.
Let me give y'all some dope Kevin TuRae history. Two was the guy that said, Kevin, get in my car. I'm gonna take you around and I'm gonna let you just jump on stage for a couple minutes. Before I go on, before I close out a show. Didn't know about comedy, wasn't getting no money. I got nothing but a bunch of stories and a bunch of weed smoke at the time, and I didn't smoke weed. So I remember being high and not knowing what was going on and asking this, are you sick from the food that we ate, or is this what? And two's famous, just be shut up and listen, I'm giving you lessons. And I didn't know it at the time, but I got lessons. I got exposure, man. I love you for that. And I know we don't talk, but I don't change. I don't forget. And that's why I wanted to make sure that you were here tonight. Let me bring those comedians back to the stage, man. Lawrence, Anthony, Skeet, come back up here tonight. Come on up here, man. This right here. This is what comedy is in Philadelphia. You got your comedy clubs, but if you got a routine group of people that come back and to show you love in this environment, you got a guy that takes his heart and that gives it and that makes sure that you guys got people to tell jokes to, that's bigger than anything to me. People, please give these guys a round of applause for tonight. Once again, I love y'all. Thank y'all for coming. I appreciate y'all. This is Heart of the City. Come up. Anybody want a drink?
I'm ready now.
I'm in there, baby. I'm in there. Yeah. Hey, brown make you get down. I'm talking about putting in that sound. This drink called the upside down, because after you drink it, you're going to go upside down. Woo! Woo! You'll get your butt shook up. Huh? I just made you a martini. Because it's brown, I put the brown.